So I went ahead and I put that up there, and then we'll go ahead and we'll get started. Just FYI, there are some trains in the background, so if you hear a little bit of rumbling, it's trains. So we'll keep an eye on that. All right? All right, y'all. So here's how we're going to start. You're going to start with the rifle in your right hand, okay? You're going to take that index finger, and you're going to put it right over the top of the gun. Just like this, okay? It's really important that that index finger is there. It's gonna make this little first thing that we do pretty easy, okay? You're gonna stand in a nice, comfortable second position, right? When the music starts, the gun is gonna come straight up. You're gonna lift it up, try to keep the top of the barrel straight up and down, right? And then from here, you're just gonna open up into a nice little S-curve shape, okay? So as the music comes in, it's gonna go up, dip, 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 then you're gonna open to the side, boom, boom, okay? Nice little S-curve shape. You can't see it, but I'm gonna force start to dig with my left foot, okay? From here, all right, this is why that index finger is important. You're gonna pull the gun towards you, okay? Now, where people like to go a little funky with this little release, okay, is that you guys always try to lift up to get the rifle to do what it needs to do. And you don't want to do that. You want to think about pulling the butt towards you, okay? That's going to make that happen much easier. So think about pulling the butt towards you, and that's going to make that happen, okay? Yep. Rifle comes up, over, boom, grab. Now, when you grab the gun, we're going to try to grab it between the clip and the top of the bolt, okay? You're going to grab it just like this. So, lift, duck, pull, boom, trap, okay? So you're gonna have to let it go down a little bit, otherwise you're gonna catch in the neck. If we don't wanna catch in the neck, we wanna catch you, okay? So I'm gonna play that first part with you so you get an idea of how fast it is, and we'll see what happens. City's cold and empty, all the world around us judge me. I can see clearly when you're gone. We definitely get moving and grooving right away. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and go on. There's some feet. Yes, absolutely. I'll do it away from everybody so everybody can see that as well. All right. Let's do that again. All right, cool. I'm gonna tilt the hammer angle down just a little bit so you can see my feet in this next part. Okay. Okay. As soon as you pull this up, you gotta step across with the left foot. Okay? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Step. Okay, left foot steps across. You're gonna keep the gun going. Gun pulls this direction, I get a hold of it. I'm gonna keep going with the gun and I'm gonna step through into a second position. Okay? The gun just dives over down. At this point, my strap is gonna be going to my left. Okay? Start. Foot. Step, step into a second position. From here, I'm gonna step back with my left leg. So feet wise so far. We went second position. Or start, step across, step to second, step back. Okay? Again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Step left, step right, step left. Make sure that foot goes behind, okay? As we take that step with our left foot, the gun, I'm just gonna release a nice little baby. A little bit more than a baby. It's about a full single, okay? Full single grab. And I'm gonna grab in the same spot. So it's between the clip, the top of the bolt. I'm gonna grab between the clip, the top of the bolt, okay? So I'm gonna try that again, giving you guys a lot of counts, okay? And I'll go through it just a little bit slow. All right, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. step left, step right, step left. And it's just gonna transfer right into my left hand. Left foot is stepped behind, all the way across, okay? Now, from here, right, what we're gonna do is we're gonna set the gun on my shoulder, okay? So as soon as I grab it, I'm gonna set it on my shoulder. And all I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna unwind my feet. So my feet didn't go anywhere. My feet are twisted, right? I grab the gun, I'm gonna set it on my shoulder, and I'm gonna keep everything in the toaster plate. Everything in the toaster plate all the way down around to the front. You notice my right arm just follows the gun nice and easy. Grab, arm pulls out, unwind, boom. I get all the way to this shape. Okay? So again, with counts. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And this gets us all the way to count 16. Okay? Any questions so far? I know that's a lot of shenanigans right there at the beginning. I'll do it with music a couple times. I'll do it both facings. Any questions so far? Go ahead and type them in the group chat. All right, I'm going to do it with music. Cool. Any questions, y'all? If you want to take just like a minute or two and kind of go through that, that's totally fine. If you have any questions, throw it in the little group chat function and we'll try to answer them. Yes, absolutely. I'll go through it with counts. All right. All right. So, second position. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. When you get to this shape, make sure the strap is toward you. The bolt is away from you. Right. 5, 6, 7, 8. You pull this 9. Grab 10. 11. 12. Grab 3rd. Drop 4, turn 5, 6, right? Facing this way, because sometimes it's easier. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Your feet just stay kind of twisted up there for just a second. What count do we catch the second pop? Four. It's on 14, it's like 13 and 14. Go for count 14. Aim for count 13, because you want to be a little bit on the fast side. It's going to be quick. It's just a little small release. If you lift up too high, you're going to wind up catching this really, really super slow. Okay, so keep it nice and tight. It's just a little backhand. Backhand grab. Yeah, so it's just a little quick transfer. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so it's really on the end count of 13. Okay, any other questions real quick? All right, I'm going to do that one more time with music, and then we'll go ahead and we'll go on.
I'm cities cold and empty. No one's around to judge me. I can see clearly when you're gone.
All right, so here's where it gets a little bit fun, because the planes are a little bit weird, but trust and believe we'll get through this. Okay? So I just steps across. And I unwound, boom. So now my left foot's in front. Okay? Lower body wise, all we're going to do is we're going to brush. We're just going to undo our feet. So my right foot is behind. It's really just an in-place release up. I just don't travel. Up, right, left. That's all that happens with the lower body. Okay? So I unwind, grab, fifth, six, yep, all I do, get my feet out from underneath. The gun, okay? The gun is going to drop down. Now notice the tip goes between my arm and my lower body, okay? So if you try to keep it in front of you, never gonna work, okay? You have to drop it down. Fully extend this arm to get it down and away from you, okay? I'm gonna twist the gun, right? So as soon as it's between my arm, I'm going to twist, and I'm gonna get the bolt up. I'm just gonna dump my water out all the way to flat, okay? So again, I just finished my turn. I drop the gun down, boom, boom, to flat. So again, drop the gun down, but right here, twist this arm and get it all the way to flat, okay?
I know that's kind of funky because you're really carving the rifle through a huge spatial plane, but keep it nice and big. Big open up and don't let that arm be nice and small. You've got to fully extend it down, fully extend it down, and I'm even leaning so that I have more room. Right? I'm leaning down, twist the gun so the bolt is up, and then holding on to it, I'm just carving all the way to the flat plate. Okay? So, all together.
Six. It drops down, up, flat. Okay? From here, this is really easy. I'm just gonna turn, and I'm gonna grab it with my right hand on this side. I'm not doing this, no. On this side in the neck. So I unwind it, press down, up to flat, bring it around, grab it with my right hand. Okay, so I'm gonna try to give you all some counts, but it's just kind of real quick. So I'm going to try to give you a little cube count, okay? Here we go. 12, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th. This is going to drop down on 1. This is really kind of count 4. 2, 4, 6, 8. So let's say we'll be here by count 8. If that changes, I'll let you know. We'll say we'll be here by count 8, okay? I got 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 4, 5, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8-ish. Okay, 8-ish. Now, want me to go through that one more time, or you want to just keep going on? Quick pull.
Jared?
Yes?
Can you do all that again, walking through, but facing away from us?
Of course.
Thank you.
I just ended. Right foot is behind, left foot is in front. I just finished turning to this. Right, left, 4-star stick, bring it around into another 4-star stick. Okay, that's about 8 counts. Okay, okay. One, eight, okay? Keep that right hand on the neck. And you want to grab it on this side, not that side. Cool? All right, let's do that much so far with music, and let's see how we do. So this shape is totally count six, not eight. Totally count six. Okay? So it's quick. This is four, three, four, then quick around your body, five, six. Okay? If you connect that hand to your hip when you get here on count four, it's way easier to get this around. But if you keep that rifle separate, you're gonna be chasing it the entire time. Okay? I'll do it facing this way. Cool? Baby, so far, so good, y'all. All right, let's go on. So, four, six. What's going to happen is I'll show you the rifle first, then I'll show you the lower body. Okay? Is I'm going to unwind the gun. That's it. Unwind down. Now, when I finish the down, I'm going to connect the gun to my forearm. So I'm here, unwind down, connect it to my forearm from this angle, right? Unwind down. Okay? And this is real low. This is a real nice little baby. Boom, boom. And it's down. Okay? The most important part here is that we actually connect the gun to the forearm. Okay, some of y'all with smaller hands are gonna be like, whoa, wait a second, but I've got a little quick thing for you. Okay, so again, unwind down, okay? Lower body wise, okay? So we just unwound, turn, is I'm gonna brush my right leg up, and it's just gonna be a quick right, left, right, okay? Right, right, left. Right foot brushes through, right up, right left. And that's when I finish on this down angle connected to my core from this perspective. Right up, right left. Don't worry about this free arm, just kind of let it be expressive in the moment, right? But so far, everything that we've done so far is it just transferred around, right? So as this right left arm pulls up, just let it come up. Let it come down with the gun, okay? So again, I just made that connection. Up, down. Let your focus come up right before you come down. Does that make sense? Okay, I'm gonna start from here, and I'm gonna connect all those pieces together, okay? Right leg is behind, it drops down. Right, left for start, bring it around. Right, left. Down, I've made the connection here. Okay. Now, going on from here, and this is where everybody likes to struggle a little bit, okay? And this is where being tall helps, but everybody who's short can do it too, okay? Is that once I've made the connection here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna lift the gun up, and I'm gonna set it on my shoulder. Now, for those of you that have small arms, small hands, okay? Because it is connected to our forearm, it's not going to go anywhere. But we want to squeeze the gun between my forearm and my bicep. Notice my hand doesn't even need to be on it. Keep it on there for safety, right? Just to make sure it doesn't come out of our hands. Okay? But tuck it right there between your forearm and your bicep. Again, just up, down, and really squeeze, flex those muscles. Okay? down, wing. I'm gonna get all the way here to this shape. Now, from here, all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn and I'm gonna open up to the front. Notice my elbow opens right across. Even without my hand, it's really easy, okay? But you have to keep it connected to the shoulder. Don't let it come off of the shoulder, okay? Connect to the shoulder, open to the front. Now from here, again, no hand, I'm gonna keep it squeezed and I'm gonna pull back with that arm. The tip is gonna come in front of me and then I'm just gonna re-grab, okay? Boom, open up and grab. Just a little quick shoulder, okay? Little quick shoulder, I'll do it facing this way. To my shoulder, open up, pull back and grab, okay? Happens really quick, boom, boom, open, grab. You just keep the gun moving, it's gonna make it a world of difference, okay? But keep that gun tucked and attached to your shoulder, into your neck in order to get it all the way around so it doesn't fall off. If you let go, or you try to keep this, it's gonna roll all over top of your back. Keep it connected, open up, okay? All right, I'm gonna start from here, right? We're gonna do the glissade, and I'm gonna get all the way through to that little neck roll with the gun, okay? Down, up, pull up, 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 boom. So boom, shoulder, open up. Notice this arm comes up at the same time. I'm doing that so the gun has something to roll over top. Open this first step. Down, pull, six, boom. Connect to my shoulder. Yes, Steph?
If you guys have any questions, please feel free to throw it in the group chat, but I'm gonna do that much with music facing both directions, okay? So for those of you that missed it, this is count 12 once you finish the little shoulder. Okay, I'll do it again facing the other direction. Go ahead and work on that for just a hot hand count. If you have any questions, type them in. I'm gonna get a little water. And if y'all can't tell, it's actually raining here in Houston, so. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna go all the way from the beginning again, all the way through to that count 12. Cool, and then we'll go on. All right, y'all, for that last part, this is the whole place of a femur torsion. Great question. Connects down here, the bolt is away from me. The strap is towards my neck.
strap is towards my neck, so the bolt is away. Well, great question.
Right. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna go on a little bit. Yeah.
So, count 12. What's gonna happen here is I'm just gonna do an X jump with the gun attached to my hand, right? So I just went open up. I'm gonna change plane using this arm here. So I'm flat and I'm just gonna lift up, right? I'm gonna grab into a second position. I like to do action. You're going to let the gun come out as you open up into F's all the way down. Okay, and it was a little confusing. I'll go through it again. Boom. Change plane. Boom. I'm going to end with my hips facing this end zone. I'm not going to finish all the way to the back. I'm going to shorten that X jump just a little bit. Yeah. Hips that direction, okay? Yeah. Yes. Okay. Now, I'm gonna keep going up. 12. Tilt, third, spin, six. This is count 16. Notice my hand has never left the same spot in the bowl. Grab it here, turn, open up, down. Hand has not moved at all. It's gonna stay there a little bit longer. And step up. My right leg is gonna pull up into a passe as the gun continues the motion. Down, up, down. Down, up, and down. Okay. Hand stays in the exact same spot of the gun. My hand has not left.
Shopping, Jared?
What?
Have you been shopping? Is that your Amazon order?
Maybe.
That's fine.
All right, I'm going to go through that again. I'm going to face the other direction.
X jump. Left foot is forward. Right foot pulls up. Lunge. Lunge. Cool. Real easy, so far. Yeah. I get up to that lunge. I'm going to bring the gun down, and I'm going to do a small circle as my right foot steps across. So lunge, bring it back through second, weight goes to my left foot, small circle, down. Okay, so big circle, small circle, down. And again, pausing in big circle, small circle, down.
My left hand is just along for the ride. Okay. This is where people like to get tricked up, is that they like to do too much with the left hand. Left hand is just along for the ride. Okay. Up, grab the tip. It stays on the gun, but it's just along for the ride. I'm going to make sure that the gun continues the motion all the way through. Okay, so up, down, up, down. Okay, now from here. Okay, and I'm gonna go through and do all that facing the other direction again. Okay, but I'm gonna show you the next thing that happens because now your left hand is working. Okay, small circle, boom. I'm gonna open up the palm. Little metronome for y'all.
Hey, do you know what it reminds me of?
What's that?
It's like if we're at camp and we're out on the quad and those lawnmower guys come around and you
hey, that might start here in a little bit if the rain clears up. All right, y'all, so going through that again. So up, big circle, small circle, down. Right foot steps across. I'm gonna open up my left palm and I'm just gonna turn the gun. That's all that happens. So I finish my big circle, my small circle, down. I'm gonna squeeze it here so that I can change plane, and now it's in my left hand. Left hand is over, switch, thumb towards me, right hand comes off. Okay. Again. Pause it. Big circle, left hand's along for the right, squeeze at the down angle. Switch my left hand, thumb is up, knuckles towards the audience, boom. Just open it up, okay? Facing the other way. Pause it. Big circle, small circle, step across, switch the hand, lunge, okay? Happens pretty quick, right? So, that's six. One, two, three, four, six. Two. Okay, okay. Up. Big circle, small circle, turn left. Okay. Let's see what that looks like from the beginning so we can get you guys some counts. Pretty sure that second up is on six, though.
City's cold and empty. No one's around to judge me. You can see clearly when you're gone.
So, count-wise, I'm count 22, right? Okay. One, four, count four, six, seven, nine. Count nine. I'll face this way. Let's do it from the other side.
City's cold and empty.
Y'all, it's real slippery. You see all that? Well, why don't you take a moment, piece all that together. If you have any questions, throw them my way. We only have like another 16 left to go. Okay, so we've got plenty of time. Plenty of time. If you guys got questions, let me know. Y'all, I'm out of breath. All right, y'all, let's finish up. So, boom, nine, four, six, nine. I keep my weight, my left foot. I'm actually just gonna do a nice little turn. So I connect the gun to my body, right foot steps through. Today, down, and I step right back out. Up, four, six, eight, nine, 10, 11, ish. Okay, from here, I'm just gonna do a nice little handshake. Then it's gonna lift up,
I'm going to grab at the bolt, okay? Excuse me, at the neck. Straight up above. Grab. Now, some of y'all are going to try to flip it out of your hand. You're going to try to pull down to get this gun to do what it needs to do. Don't do that. Lift the butt up. The gun's going to do the rest of the work for you. Up. It's just going to go right over top of your head. But up. And that's it. Try to put too much on it. It's going to wind up doing a whole bunch of flips that are unnecessary. Okay? So you get here. Up. The hand just goes right across your body. Up. To my shoulder. Grabbing here in the neck. Okay, seven, 1, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, but up, right across the box. Okay, do that facing this way. Up, 4, 6, 8, 9, turn 10, up and right. Okay, now, from here, boom. This is gonna be real easy. I'm gonna pull my left foot into my right, and I'm gonna shift my hips to this 45. Not to the end zone, not to the front, to the 45. To the front, front, 45. I'm just gonna do a nice little counter, the tip of the gun. Boom, down. Okay, that's pretty easy, right? Now, this is where it gets tricky, is because you're going to want to twist that bolt every which way it possibly can. So, strap is towards me. I'm going to keep this strap and my palm together the entire time. Cone, notice my strap is still up. I'm not going to finish the cone, so my strap is up the other direction. I'm going to stop it here and just twist my hand, because I want the bolt, the strap, to be down. Strap is down, strap is up, strap is up, strap is down, okay? Down, up, down, down, okay? Down, down. It's really important that we keep that strap down, because what we're about to do is a little wrist roll, and if you're on the top of the gun, it's really hard, okay? So to keep your bolt, your strap down, so we can do this little wrist roll. Okay? So we got it. 4, 6, 9, 10. Over. Strap is down. Strap is down. Okay? Strap is down. From this perspective. Up. 4, 6, 9, and up. Grab the shoulder. Small cone. Now, strap is down. Okay? Like I said, next thing that's going to happen is I'm going to lift the gun up. It's just going to twist in my wrist. Okay? People like to get a little funky with these wrist rolls. Twist my wrist. Now I'm just going to open the palm. So turn, open. The gun is just going to go over top of my hand. Twist, open, and I'm gonna grab it, and I'm gonna finish the rotation. That makes sense. Small cone, boom. Finish the rotation, grabbing up. Okay. 1, 4, 6, 9, 12, pull the length, and up. And I'm going to throw my left hand on it in that moment. Cone. Boom. Okay. Pretty simple. Right? From here. And yes, I will go back through all of this. I will go back through all of this. Okay? Boom. I'm going to push the gun away from me. The butt pulls towards me. If you're short, it happens. Open up this right hand so we can slide down the gun. If you're short, just open up the hand. If you're tall like me, keep your hand on it. Just roll, grab, push out, down. I'm gonna re-square up back to the front. So here, So from this perspective, flat in front of me, punch down. Everything's at the 45. 45. Wrist roll. I punch to the 45, right foot steps across. Boom. And I'm changing my plane to the other 45. So I'm working at my 45s right now. 45. Facing the 45. Right foot steps towards the 45. Second position to the opposite 45. Cool. All right. Again, I will go through all of this one more time. Okay? And I'll do it that direction. Once you get here, real easy. Just a little flip. I think y'all know it's coming. So boom, boom, boom. Grab them straight up and down. I'm going to do a nice little lot to dip. I'm going to throw my own adventure. Okay? So one more time, this direction, then I'll explain it all this direction. Okay? So I just went up, right? Flat to the front. Cone to the 45. My strap stays down, so I can do this nice little wrist roll, boom. Okay? I push the tip away from me as my right foot steps across. I square back up to the front. My strap is up. My bolt is down. My right hand is between the clip and the bolt. I'm just going to release that half flip, straight up and down. Choose your own adventure. Throw a quad or a ball. Okay? The other direction. 45. Strap stays down. Wrist roll. Working at my 45s. Right foot steps towards the 45. We're up to the 45. Now flip. Step down and up and back. Okay? One more time, and I'll do it a little bit more up close in case you need to see some more details. Okay? Boom. Small cone. Strap stays down. Wrist roll up. Both hands grab. Okay? If you're short and you have short arms, that's okay. Open up the right hand so this can pass through your body. Open up the right hand. As you step across, readjust that hand closer to the clip. Half flip. Straight up and down. Dip. If you're quarter dipper, go ahead and quarter dip. If you're a full dipper, full dip, and you're throwing a quad or a thigh. Other direction. Small cone. Strap this down. Wrist roll. Slide the hand if you need it. Step down into a second position. Top spot. Dip. And down. Cool. I know that's a lot of little tricky hand back and forth, but it really stays in the same spot on the gun between the bolt and the clip a lot of the time. Okay, so I'm gonna piece all this together. I'm gonna do it for y'all, okay? I might throw a quad, don't be.
City's cold and empty. No one's around to judge me. I can see clearly when you're gone.
I'll do that again, and then I will give y'all some counts because I know y'all are hurting.
City's cold and empty. No one's around to judge me. I can see clearly when you're gone. On my side. My blinds by the lies. No, I can't sleep in it till I feel your touch. I said, I'm drowning in the night.
Questions, comments, concerns, anxieties, anybody? Go ahead and type them in. And I'll get a recording for you guys that we can just throw up on YouTube that's just the ditty, so that'll help y'all.
Jared?
Yes.
Are you going to record just the ditty?
Yes. And then I'll send it to you.
Okay, or I can send you the information and just put it right on our Color Guard YouTube page.
That works too.
Or whatever.
All right, I will do it again that way and this way. If you have any questions, type them in. It's my typing, right? Throw them in there and I'll do my best to answer them for you. Here we go. Twice more through.
Yay, Jared, thank you.
I'm out of breath and it's raining.
Those twirls are cute. Thanks. I love how they take up so much space. Like, you really move around a lot.
I'm working on it. I'm working on that.
Fun stuff.
Me, I like to stand in second and give you a little twirly twirl.
I love me a good standing in second feature.
Moment.
The video's going. Okay, I see a question here. No, we are not using the Google Share. What we are doing is we now have a Music for All YouTube account, Color Guard specific. So if you just search on YouTube, Music for All Color Guard, you should be able to find our account pretty quick. And I don't have any of these uploaded yet because I've been doing Zoom after Zoom after Zoom today. So tonight I will get all of today's uploaded. So they'll just be on YouTube. So we don't have to worry about sharing Google passwords, and Google confuses me sometimes, but that's where it's going to be available to anybody. I also want to encourage you, those of you that are on here, if you are not in our Facebook group community, to please join that, especially instructors. Our CGIA Facebook group, which you just search CGIA Music for All Color Guard Instructor Academy, you should find it pretty easy. That group has, it's so active all year long. Like, you can post questions and you'll get answers not only from faculty, but from other instructors from around the country. It's a really great resource. And if you're a student, we do have a Color Guard Music for All Summer Symposium Color Guard Facebook page too. It's not as active as the grownups because, you know, old people, we love Facebook. But we do have a Music for All MFA _ color _ guard Instagram account. And I just started a TikTok account. And you can cringe because I am a little bit cringy, but really I love watching what you guys are doing on TikTok. It's pretty cool how much Color Guard is actually out there on TikTok. It's fun. All right. So thank you, Jared. So this whole Zoom will be up. So if you want to learn the breakdowns, that'll still be here. And then Jared's going to record just the ditty and we'll get that up on the YouTube page as well. Anything else, Jared?
Thank you all for coming out. I hope you had some fun. I'm a little rain and sweat, but you know,
we can go get you some donut or piece of pizza or something. You earned it.
Hello, let's go.
All right, everybody, have a great night. Megan Brackett is doing a beginning rifle technique. If you are in, especially instructors looking for teaching youngins, she's over on the Instagram live at 4:00, and then we have some other content coming up here. If you join that Facebook group, we've got all the content on the Facebook group. All right, y'all, thanks for a great session, Jared.
Thanks for playing.
We'll see you later.